Hey guys, welcome to the stream. I'm just catching up on a bunch of sports games right now. Yeah, controlling the flow of second chance opportunities is the key. It's something they'll try to replicate tonight. Kennard kicks to Morris.
First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Pass to Kennard. Come on, y'all. 16. Shot clock at 6. I'll be taking it. Out of bounds.
So take a look at some numbers for Jordan. And guys, how about the surge of offense he's experiencing right now? These last 5 games, he's been a machine at the offensive end. A different score than he had been earlier in the season. We'll find out if he can keep it going here tonight. The defense with no impact at all. Just didn't have the feel.
Let's try this again.
Well-placed alley-oop pass into the lane. And creating a little separation here.
And in one.
It looks like they're just one step ahead right now, looking to build out their advantage even further. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around. Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum. Charlotte, no good that time either.
Hey, I see why y'all 11 and 19.
From 20 feet out. He can't get that one to fall. And Charlotte will go the other way with it. Coming into this,
come on, Jordan.
Against Cleveland in their last game. And you know what? Sometimes it's hard to say whether or not defensively you were on your game. But bottom line is their opponent didn't shoot it well. And you got to take some of the credit from the defensive team.
Oh, I have a laptop. So soon I'll be streaming from my laptop rather than my actual console. As soon as I get everything I need, I got the software downloaded and everything. But I need that capture card, and I need to put the virus protection on my laptop, and then I'll be good to go.
In terms of their performance, the 76ers shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game, and they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line. And the first one drops.
Alright, that's one down.
And so Jordan nails both of them.
Well, that's two down.
Shooting is something they never need to worry about. He doesn't even know how to go through the coast.
And the Hornets call timeout.
Well, it's been an express lane to the rim. Coach can't be happy about that. Four rotations. I mean, slow help and just not enough toughness on the interior. They've got a lot to talk about. This is the 2K leaderboard with a rundown of the NBA's top defenders down low. The league's leaders in rejections this month. You look at Freak,
second in the NBA, a great defender. And, of course, Taj Gibson, several spots down. He's also someone that will flat out control the paint.
So we're not going to talk about the number one spot?
Special low post defense. And a lot of the shots I've seen them swatting away are easy to get to.
Westbrook, no good. Here's McDaniels, guarded by Jordan. McDaniels passes to Kennard.
Well, what type of name is what? McMahon.
Over Butler. Matt, no luck.
Well, he has to work harder to get a good high percentage look. I mean, he's been taking some bad shots.
Here's Kobe. Butler. A chance there to pass it double digits, but it's off the mark. Shot to stop the run, and Morris with the lay-in.
Great teamwork, punctuated by a strong finish. Perfect example of how to run the break the right way.
And jump ball, jump ball, jump ball.
Jump ball is tied up there. And here are the Hornets now. Here's Westbrook. The shot is good.
30.
And so is his shooting tonight. 3 for 4.
And the story here, Kevin, early on, is how well they've shot the basketball.
Hornets trail by 9. Here's Morris.
And it's sent back.
And one of the league's most effective shot blockers in that guard position. Jordan can do it.
Let's go, Jordan.
Or on the ball. And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
Well, you think defensively that you're trying to pack in the lane. That opens up some opportunities for the shooter.
And that's an example of playing big, adapting to the situation.
Well, your difficult finish, but you expected him to back down. Got to think he did. Charlotte shooting their first foul shot of the night.
And as a unit, they're shooting 78% from the line. That's a solid number to work with on the season.
Hey, Chris, this year pioneer Chuck Cooper inducted into the Basketball Hall of Fame. Long overdue, wouldn't you say?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, he was the first African-American player ever to be drafted. I mean, dude, let's just think about that. Mm-hmm. Jackie Robinson of basketball. He paved the way and what he endured. And his teammates, by the way, of all colors, is well documented. And I think the Celtics need to, and I think they will retire his number 11 and have it hang up in the famed Raptors of theirs over there.
And
already, they've staked out a noticeable advantage in terms of aggression and controlling the backcourt.
Morris with the ball. He's picked up by Jordan.
You know what? Water foul. Just water foul.
The Hornets shooting their second and third free throws tonight. First one falls for Charlotte, making some changes. Kevon Looney is checked in for McGinn, and Tim Hardaway Jr. subbed in for Kennard. Then for the 76ers, Freaks checked in for Butler. James Harden comes in for Bryant, and Allen Iverson is subbed in for Russell Westbrook.
Oh yeah, tomorrow is Friday, which means I'm back to streaming. Shadow of the Tomb Raider. I don't know why I keep thinking of Shadow of the Colossus.
The last game against the Hawks in Atlanta.
And there really was a physical aspect of his performance.
That game was annoying.
He was taking it right at him, and he just kept getting those calls and getting to the line.
Now, sometimes it just looks unfair with the way Harden can create space. And then, Chris, he'd get that shot up.
It's just a step-back jumper. It's a thing of beauty. I'm not talking about his almost travel double step back, just his regular one. I mean, he has so many tools to create space with his footwork, and he makes the most out of what you give him.
What do you guys think of a God of War anime series instead of a live action series? James Harden and what he's done these last few years, you have to do it on a very historic level.
He's going to go down as one of the best to ever play the game. His production is incredible, and the skill level really is groundbreaking. Easily the best off guard in the league.
And both free throws good for James Harden.
Yeah, and early on, doing a really nice job at the free throw line.
Outside Hardaway.
And of course, a foul.
So he'll get a chance at the line. It's going to be on Michael Jordan.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
The Hornets have yet to miss from the free throw line. They're 3 for 3. The first one falls. Hardaway hits them both. Here's Freak.
They're down by 4.
Standing game against Atlanta. And the rebound goes to the Hornets.
41 points, 15 rebounds.
Here's Morris.
Talk about a double.
Iverson with some nice D. The 76ers leading by 4. Here's Jordan. Here's Freak. It's deflected. And out of bounds as the Hornets gain possession.
Hey, if it got deflected, then why I still don't got possession of it?
Poor Jordan. His last 10 games have been exceptional. First in blocks, second in free throw percentage, and he has so many different ways to get the ball in the basket. Right now, ranked 3rd in the league in points per game.
He has been a human highlight reel all season long. Clearly the best shot blocker in the game right now, and he has the numbers to back it up. Charlotte calls timeout.
Trying to find some answers offensively. Bad shot selection, as well as some bad luck. I mean, that's not going to help you score points.
Another time out.
And here are the Hornets now. 4-point game. Pass to Washington. And here's Porter. Second chance shot. And the layup is good.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
Y'all going to stop blocking my shots.
Goes down and gets this game back to even. Porter's got his second basket of the night.
And he's just adept at scoring it in so many ways. It's clear Porter very...
Oh, come on.
Inside. The 2 fouls and we're not even out of the first quarter. That's not a good case to set.
And Philadelphia making a change here. Thompson's checked in. So it's Charlotte with it. Morris passes to Looney, kicks to Porter. Looney down low.
Really? A foul?
So far, nothing on the scoreboard yet. And 2 free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
Yeah, the defender all over.
Well, when you look at a guy like Kevin Looney, I mean, he gives his team so much. I mean, great option to have him starting or off the bench with his versatility.
Free throw, no good. And Chris, with Looney, he is a bit of a glue guy, and his defense is his calling card.
Well, he slots into so many lineups as he can play the four or the five and basically guard anyone on the floor. He has a good motor and doesn't need a ton of touches to be effective.
Now the free throw is good, now leading by one.
Oh no, we gotta fix that.
Shooting at around 44% in the early goings here. And Iverson gets it to go.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
And Morris has got the ball here for the Hornets. Outside Hardaway. Misses the three. Philadelphia with the ball. And Thompson kicks to Iverson.
Oh, not us.
And Allen Iverson the bucket, the assist by Thompson. Now it's a 3-point 76ers lead. Here are the Hornets with the ball. They're on a 14-6 run. Morris against Iverson. Morris passes to Hardaway. Charlotte moving it around. And here is Morris. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Over Iverson. Morris.
I'll be taking it.
His field goal percentage has dipped this quarter. I mean, his movement has to be better. He has to find the open spot for the floor.
It's tipped. Back to Porter. And it's Freak with the rebound. Philadelphia leading by 3. It's going by
really?
Morris. Yeah, clearly he had an established position there.
All right, Sixers, what's up? Why are y'all getting enough about fouls?
Edge, Chris, for example, certain guys are just so deceptive with the ball in their hands. I mean, you're always looking for whatever can give you that advantage.
Two of the best players, and people can complain as much as they want, but Harden getting to the line is genius because he knows how you're guarding him, and basically you got to stay away from him to guard him because he's so skilled. And by the way, Curry does the same thing, and Curry, one of the smaller players in the league, but always finding a way to take the contact, take the bump, but to get the scoring up. And I think as a fan for me, it's fun watching the cat and mouse game between the offensive player and the defender, seeing who can get the best of each other while involving the ref.
Well, they just control their bodies so well. They know exactly what they need to do to get that call.
And it's all on the spur of the moment. I mean, this is right. All on the fly. Such genius.
Flying high and throwing it down.
And that's what I call a dunk.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys. Hornets trail by 3. A 1:50 left to play in the first. Pass to Washington. Lead pass was put in just the right spot. Washington's got his second bucket of the night.
Well, and in terms of size, that's a mismatch he'll exploit every time, especially inside.
Iverson, the shot is good.
And there we go.
And so is his shooting tonight.
It's back to a 3-point game.
Charlotte's gone, just 1 of 4 from 3-point range here in the first. The pass to Porter. Over Thompson. Porter.
I'll be taking that.
The 76ers leading by 3. And that one's good. 3.
Now we're leading by 5.
Second bucket of the game to go.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Morris dishes the Porter. There's 47 seconds left in the first.
That's just the product of good pass work. I mean, nice team basketball right there.
Washington's gotten all 3 of his shots to fall for him. 3-4-3.
Boom!
By Iverson.
And Iverson Jefferson constantly driving to the basket, using that speed and athleticism to kind of wheel his way to the rim.
Outside Porter. 30 seconds left here in the first quarter. Hardaway with it. Now guarded by Gibson. Pocket six. Outside Porter. The Hornets need to get a shot off here. Hardaway for three. Another shot. Washington, that's good. Washington's got 8 points.
And he's caught fire this quarter yet to miss a shot.
Iverson with the bucket.
He's so aggressive.
That's what I'm talking about.
And that's the quality all great scorers have.
And the wide open shot for Morris. And Charlotte again with the bucket.
Oh, that should have counted.
Philadelphia ahead, up by three. We'll be back shortly live from Spectrum Center. What stands out to you guys from the 76ers in this one?
What we saw in that first quarter, they won their matchups defensively.
Yeah, they really got after it. I mean, they made life extremely difficult for the shooters, which is why they hold this lead.
Let's get this second quarter underway.
Washington. Then there's Tim Hardaway Jr.
And y'all gonna follow me. And I got the N1.
And it's Morris at the point. So that's who Charlotte starts the second with. 76ers have made all of their free throws so far tonight, going 6 for 6.
Alright, I ain't had time for you, freezing.
And so it's Morris with it. He'll bring it up for the Hornets. They trail by 6. They get to take on the Heat at Miami after this one. That'll be just one game played a win from home for them.
That's a perfect setup. Solid screen, defender can't avoid it. Opens up a clear path to the bucket.
Free.
No, I ain't messing with you.
And just tacks a few more points onto their lead with the tomahawk.
Ah, that's bringing it down hard. Freak's gone 67% from the field. 4 of 6. Morris looking over the floor. Passes it to Looney. And it's in there.
Facilitating from the inside, and that can be a valuable asset from any offense.
The 76ers leading by 4.
Of course, it's by 4.
And around a minute gone here in the second.
Thanks for being leaving him wide open.
Freak. They're doing a really good job of getting the ball inside and attacking the paint. That's an area they have completely dominated.
Hardaway against Harden. It's Hardaway with the drive. They get it back. The shot by Looney, no good.
Yeah, I can see why y'all 11 and 19.
It's just a fluke.
Because of stuff like that.
Throws it down.
Give them credit. Offensively, they've been the more efficient.
It's because of stuff like that.
It's because of the looks they're getting. Their offense has created some great.
I'll just let him ride open. Leave him wide open.
Anderson against Morris. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. Chris, of the guys you went against and played against, who would have benefited from today's style of play the most?
Oh, man, I got a few names. Billy Owens, to me, was a guy like a Kevin Durant. No, he couldn't shoot like that, but he did everything on the floor for us there in Golden State. And I think in today, an open game for him where he could get going, oh, man, that would just be incredible. I also think of a guy like Detlef Schrempf. He could post up, he could pop and pick, he could shoot the ball deep, he could shoot off the dribble, finish on the break. Whenever you want it, he could give it to you that way. And I think for both guys, that size, that sweet spot, 6'7", 6'8", but played like a little bit of a guard, those two guys come to mind.
Looking at who's out there now for the Hornets. Next, chipped in for Looney. McDaniels comes in for Washington. And it's Luke Kennard in for Tim Hardaway Jr.
We're sleeping.
And he sinks the second. And it's the 76ers with the ball. Stolen by McDaniels.
How you drop it?
Morris passes to Kennard. There's McDaniels. And there's the bucket. Steve with it on the offensive glass, getting it done. McDaniels got 7 points. Here's Collison. And he gets
going to follow me.
Free throws coming up.
And how about the numbers here for Butler? First in rebounding, first in blocks, and he's also ranked second in assists. Needless to say, an elite playmaker.
And just going back real quick to the fact that he's tops in the league in rebounds, what a tremendous feat. What a monster he is in the paint. Good, Darren Collison.
And the 6 foot, 175 pound Collison is a vital part of this team. A speedy point guard who can get hot in a hurry.
And both free throws good for Darren Collison.
And this is round 31 and 33.
They're taking care of business at the line.
Hornets trail by 7. Near the 3-point line, it's Morris, and misses it off the right side of the rim.
Why are y'all trying to compete? Y'all can't compete.
A little more on the backboard. That's a great way to find confidence. Always a surefire way to get back in the game.
Got that one up quick. Kennard's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game.
No, okay, I see y'all. But I'm still better than him.
And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game.
Well, there's a swagger out there. You can see it on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either. Bryant with the rebound. The 76ers leading by 6. That one off the back iron and out. Now, here's Bridges. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. The shot's good from Kennard.
I love the fact that Bridges does a little bit of everything, including passing the ball.
There's Freak.
How do you miss a dunk?
Going for the Hornets.
That ball really did just flop in the air.
Minutes played here in the second quarter. There's McDaniels. No good on the triple.
He hasn't been able to do much damage outside the 3-point line. Just one triple for him in the game.
Now y'all is not a 3-point team. Cut it out.
Hornets trail by 4. Down low, here's Matt. Basket made, just his second this contest. He's 2 for 7 now.
Okay, what is going on with
him? I mean, in the past, to hit him in stride is even better.
No, like, seriously, what is going on?
Bridges against Thompson. Morris outside. With the teardrop, make it 5 for 10 with him in that bucket.
Well, not hard to see why they are giving up points on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
Here's Bryant.
Why is this so easy?
Love seeing Bryant just get up and go for it. His leaping ability never ceases to impress.
The Hornets have gone 7-13 for the field since the start of the second. Here's Kennard, guarded by Kobe. Kennard kicks to Bridges. Six to shoot. From the arc. Rebound by Butler.
It was not me.
Seventh rebound here tonight. Damn freak throws it down.
See, you should have just tied it up.
Aggressive move and fantastic finish.
Trying to send a message with that slam, I think. Hornets trail by four. And the Hornets draw a time here. Freak really making a difference here.
Of course they call a timeout.
There should only be one thing they're talking about in this timeout. Trying to deny him the ball in the paint before he does any more damage.
Hold on, y'all.
Jordan, he's checked in for Klay Thompson. And Russell Westbrook subbed in for Darren Collison. Morris with the ball. He's picked up by Jordan. Morris with the bucket. Morris has got 7 points here in this quarter.
Well, that's not the kind of interior defense you want. Way too slow to protect.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
And of course, you'll follow me.
For Philadelphia, they have been exceptional shooting free throws tonight, going 9 for 9.
Of course, I missed one.
Making a change here. Good on the second free throw.
Down by three. I'll be taking that.
Jordan's got 4 rebounds now tonight. And Freak throws it down.
Oh, he just punches that one down with a fury. He rubs it in a little deeper with the hanging finish.
Charlotte's gone 1-4 from 3-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for them. Shot by McDaniels, no good.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
And there we go.
Yeah, this is what happens when you have a scorer like Jordan on the floor. He attracts all that attention defensively, leaving guys wide open.
Here's Morris. The dish to Matt. 2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Enough with the fouls.
First trip to the line for him here. And he makes the first. Drops them both. And here are the 76ers now. Here's
Let's go, Kobe.
Again, Philadelphia.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, right? I mean, the D is worrying too much about the other four guys. I mean, they can't give them open jump.
Here's McDaniels. He's got seven.
All right, what you got? What you got, McDaniels?
Tried to shoot.
Oh!
And foul on the shot. He'll shoot.
Butler about to get fouled out.
This is his first free throw of the game. The first free throw is good.
Ah, 60-55.
The 76ers leading by five. Tries from 16, and the 76ers tack on two more.
And this is why I'm so much better.
It has paid off in a big way.
Morris against Westbrook. Morris, no good.
Dang, Westbrook just denied Jordan from getting the rebound.
They can look forward to the Cavaliers after this game in a matchup against Cleveland. They're in the midst of a four-game road trip right now. That'll be game number three. Charlotte's gotten into trouble with the three ball in the second quarter. They're hitting one of five attempts. Out to the right wing. Now here's Matt, defended by Butler. That is good, and the 76ers lead is cut down now to just seven on the bucket from Matt.
Nice job getting inside for the layup. Got
the seven. Boom!
Puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, GA. He really does put pressure on you.
And guys, it's clear, though, he enjoys showing off his athleticism. The D can't give him these opportunities.
Kennard gets to Matt. Shoots it.
Ooh, give me that.
Rebound by Jordan. Jordan's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. He dishes it to Westbrook. Outside for Jordan. Let's it go from the wing. And the
let's go, Jordan.
Two more.
And just beautiful form on MJ's jumper. A part of the game he polishes more and more every year.
Here's Johansson. Score of the basket. Nice shot after missing his first attempt.
And you're not going to pass up that kind of thing.
The 76ers leading by nine. Westbrook drives in. Quick shot there.
You know what, Westbrook? You had one job. Alright, come on, free. We out.
I mean, better than you think when he puts the ball on the floor. Learning how to lean into defenders and step back to open up the shot is a better playmaker than he gets credit for. And we should see him take on a larger role as he develops. Wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
For Philadelphia, they have shot 10 of 11 at the line. Nice work so far for them. Some changes for Charlotte. Kevon Looney is checked in for Matt. Michael Porter comes in for McDaniels. Hardaway is subbed in for Monte Morris. Taj Gibson's checked in for the 76ers.
Alright, I'm up by 10.
And both free throws good from Freak. Hornets trail by 11. Here's Kennard. He has five. On the right side. There's Looney. Danny battles for the ball. Nope. Gets the second chance bucket. Looney's got five now.
Straight up effort gets him those points. That's what it's all about.
Let's go, Jordan.
And what you like there, the Jordan never looks like he's rushing. Makes quick, solid decisions.
To the middle. Great tee that time from Jordan.
And not a night he's going to want to remember, just not really able to score the basketball.
And it's freak missing.
Playing it tough inside and prevent the layup. Gotta get the whole team pumped up.
That's the car. This is the portal. Just five on the clock. Looking to get back on track here. He lays it in. 6 points for him. Philadelphia leading by nine.
Yo, they said he ice cold tonight.
Packed in off the glass.
He's pulling out all the tricks this quarter. They can't figure out how to stop him.
Charlotte's gone 1-6 from three-point land in the second quarter. Less than 20%. But they've continued to let him fly. Hardaway. No good that time. Now the 76ers take it the other way. There's Freak. And Freak throws it down.
And just tacks a few more points onto their lead with the tomahawk.
Ah, that's bringing it down hard. Jordan against Brook. Westbrook pulls it in.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim. Well, that's why he's out there right now.
You know what?
Like this, he stands tall to prevent points. And with the lead, I like the strategy here. Continue to get the ball to guys who can do something with it.
Oh, I do too, Greg. You have to go to your best scores. I mean, it's a smart strategy, and so far, it's paying off in this game.
Master Looney.
Yo, he a Looney too. His last name Looney. So he Looney by default.
I mean, really intelligent at using the pick and roll. Porter reads the defense and it just takes what's available.
Westbrook drives in. Got
woo!
It. Seven on the night. 7 for 11 from the floor.
He's not playing around. I mean, he hit the ground running in the first quarter and he's only turned it up in the second.
Here's Kennard. The teardrop falls in. Kennard's got 7 points for the quarter.
He's finally coming around, trying to make up for that goose egg he put up in the first quarter.
Here's Westbrook.
Oh, snap. 40 seconds left.
He's going to put that one in his scrapbook. Insane dunk.
And now they're starting to rub it in. Build up a lead, and here we go, baby. It is showtime. Hornets trail by 15. 32 seconds left now here on the second. Kennard's shot is off.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor.
Oh!
It's just one of those nights where Jordan can do no wrong offensively. And let's talk about the endurance to go along with it. Wow.
Hardaway with a wide open look from outside off the mark. Westbrook drives in. It's rebounded by Charlotte.
And that's game.
And so it's Philadelphia out in front by that's 17 right. points at the end of the quarter. What a night they've had in terms of their shooting. Everything dropping in for them. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey everybody, welcome to the 2K Sports Halftime Program. I'm Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. For the 76ers, the first quarter was pretty even. At the end of the period, they held a three-point lead. They just exploded in the second quarter, grabbing the momentum and running with it. Basket after basket, and they played stingy defense. Now they've got a halftime lead that's going to be very difficult to erase. And from what we saw so far from the Sixers, Kenny, what's your takeaway?
Well, the bench came in and helped them run away with this one. Tremendous job of getting loose, getting open, and drilling shots. You always want that spark off the bench, and these guys delivered.
And Big Fella, your thoughts on the Hornets?
Well, you live by the three, and you die by the three. And today, they're dying. And as cold as they've been behind the arc, they keep firing from deep. What are you doing?
Even I said the same thing.
They can't continue with this game plan. Not working.
And that wraps up the halftime show. Third quarter set to begin in just a few.
Second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Look at Freak in this game. Guys, he has been everywhere.
In that first half, he was a hot knife, and the defense was butter, sliced right through them.
Oh, you're so right, Greg. I mean, he did a great job of attacking the seams, getting to the rim, and then finishing strong.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. So on the floor for Philadelphia, Taj Gibson is out there with Mike.
And that's how you start off the third quarter.
Then there's Kobe. And it's Westbrook in at the point guard position.
It puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, G.A. He really does put pressure on you.
Hey, guys, it's clear, though. He enjoys showing off his athleticism. The D can't give him these opportunities.
Morris. And he converts the layup. Morris has got 20.
It's a great move, and he catches the defense completely off guard.
You'd like to see a little more energy coming out of halftime with a defensive move.
And it's Freak missing.
Oh, Thomas.
And Morris has got the ball here for Charlotte. 17-point game.
How y'all let me go ahead by 17 points?
McDaniels and Charlotte in with the bucket.
He's a tough fellow to deal with when he gets below the free throw line.
76ers have gone 1-3 since starting the second half. Near the three-point line, it's Westbrook, and they cash in right away with a quick shot.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight.
Yeah, that's why he's hot. He's playing with a lot of confidence. That's why they're going to him with such consistency.
They double him with Jordan. The pass to Kennard. Charlotte moving the ball around. Morris with the bucket.
No doubt about it. He has done a ton to help his team, but he's going to have to do even more if they want to have a chance to get back in this one.
Stolen by McGann. How are you just going to steal the ball?
Morris outside. And Charlotte again with the bucket.
Hasn't taken them any time to find their rhythm in the second half. 4-for-4 from the field already.
The 76ers leading by 13. Here's Westbrook. Oh, and the jam by Westbrook.
Just rubbing it in their faces with that.
He is never going to take his foot off the pedal.
What a performer this guy is. He relishes the chance to hammer it down.
And this is his second trip to the line in the game.
And on the season, you know, only shooting around 73%, so not necessarily where he'd like to be.
And that one falls for Westbrook. Hornets trail by 16. Morris with the ball. Picked up by Bryant. It's good.
Wow. Five straight buckets coming out of half.
We're even. Maybe not, because Westbrook might have more than 40. Because it's always a clinic when these two work together.
Here's Kennard. He has seven. He feeds it to Matt. Got it. Good job in the low post. Matt's got 10 points in the game.
What a fantastic start here to the second half. They have yet to miss.
Westbrook finds Jordan. Up again.
Oh.
The miss. Max got 5 rebounds tonight. And another move for the scoring count. His big basket of the game. Now he's shooting 5 of 11.
Hold on, y'all. I'll be back on the headset in a second.